So, you're thinking of moving to Pembroke Pines, Florida. In this video, I'm gonna show you around Pembroke Pines. I'm gonna take you through different neighborhoods and show you some different homes at different price points so you can see what may fit with your budget. If you stick around until the end of the video, I'm gonna show you the neighborhood's best kept secret that you definitely don't want to miss. And we're getting after it right now. If this is your first time to the channel and you want to know everything about living in Pembroke Pines, Florida, then subscribe below, tap the bell for notifications so you can be the first to know everything about living in South Florida. My name is Michael Valencia with Living in South Florida. We get calls and emails every day from people just like you looking to make their move to South Florida. And we absolutely love it. Whether you're moving in 9 days or 90 days, give us a call, shoot us a text, or send us an email. All of the information is in the description below so we can help you make a smooth move to South Florida. Right now, I'm in Pembroke Pines. Pembroke Pines is such a large area, such a large city, that I am actually going to divide this video into three different parts. Part number one is gonna be East Pembroke Pines. Number two is gonna be Central Pembroke Pines. And part number three is gonna be West Pines, all right? Now, the reason why is because Pembroke Pines is actually the 11th largest city in the state of Florida. It currently has over 174,000 residents. That's how big it is. So for me to try to put three different properties at three different price points just in Pembroke Pines is not going to do it justice. Each area is slightly different. For example, right now in East Pines, where I am right now, you have properties that are built in 1960s, 1970s, 1980s, right? Central Pembroke Pines, you're gonna have properties that were built from 1980s to 2000, right? And then West Pines, you're gonna have everything that was built in 2000 and newer. So it's gonna be different types of properties. As you can see, this is typical 1970 construction. We have shingle roof, ranch style home. Most of these are only two bedrooms. This home that I'm actually going to be walking up to right here, they have extended driveways. This one's actually on the market right now. It's a 2-1, around 1,000 square feet with a one-car garage for $410,000 in Pembroke Pines. It was built in 1970. It has hurricane impact windows. The AC is about 7 years old. A lot of these properties here are gonna be much older. Yeah, so you're gonna see different parts of Pembroke Pines are gonna have different things to offer. Because this is the older part, the schools are still great. They're C+, B rated schools. A lot of parks, Pembroke Pines has about 28 different parks to offer. All have all sorts of different activities and amenities that they have. You're really close to Pines Boulevard, where you have plenty of shopping and dining and nightlife. Yeah, right now we're gonna go check out a property number two, which is just a few streets away, and I'll see you guys soon. As I mentioned to you before, I am currently in Pembroke Pines. This is the most east part of Pembroke Pines. I'm literally on the east side of North Perry Airport. So if you go to Google Maps, you look North Perry Airport on the east part of, this is still considered Pembroke Pines, this area, even though we're right up against Hollywood. This area of Pembroke Pines seems to have a little bit more affordable homes. But as I mentioned in my when I was walking around the first house, a lot of these homes were built in 1960. For example, I'm gonna turn around now and I'm gonna go show you guys what property that's on the market right now for $450,000. It was built in 1960, right? So a lot of these homes, as you can tell, there is no HOA, so there's no homeowners association. There is pretty low taxes, but they are older homes, right? They are homes that are either going to be fully renovated, which you will most likely pay a premium for, or such as this one. This one's really nicely renovated. It's got the metal roof, hurricane impact windows, you can just see it, and they still have the accordion shutters all the way around. You might be able to get a good deal on a property that still needs to be renovated, but it's obviously going to take some time to get it up to, you know, what a nice house like this could be going for. Like I said, this particular house, as you can see, it's got a pretty mature tree in the front. The lot is about 7,000 square foot lot. The yard is not fenced in. The windows are fairly old. This is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,300 square foot house for $450,000 in East Pembroke Pines. It's currently vacant. Not much has been updated to it. As you can see, the shingles look like they're a little bit dirty compared to the neighbor shingles, which these look brand new. And then you have this awesome house across the street that looks like it's been fully renovated. From here, I'm actually going to go into a closed gated community in Pembroke Pines, and I'm gonna show you what a $650,000 property looks like on east side of Pembroke Pines, all right? I'll see you in the next house. Hey guys, so I'm here in property number 3 in East Pembroke Pines. This particular community is called Walnut Creek. It is a closed gated community that has different sub-communities within the community. So this is the only property in today's list that is actually in an HOA. It's a closed gated community with a manned guard, meaning 24 hours a day, 365. There's actually a person at the front gate that has to check everybody in, check their IDs, and determine whether they can come into the community or not, if you're on a guest list, if somebody's expecting you. Luckily, I have some clients here that knew that I was gonna be stopping by to take this video, and they obviously put me on their list so I can come in. So thank you guys for that. This particular house that I'm showing you today, this one is a 3-bedroom. So you guys can kind of see different types of homes in this community. This one is a 3-bedroom, 3-bath, just under 2,000 square feet. It has a 2-car garage, fenced in yard. It is on the market for $555,000, all right? It's about $320 a square foot. Now, because it is in a closed gated community, there is an HOA fee. The HOA fee is a monthly fee. Some of them will be quarterly, all others will be yearly. For this particular community, it's a monthly cost of $284 a month where I'm standing. But the cool thing about some of these closed gated communities is not just the fact that, you know, it's closed gated, you have security that drives by, so it's pretty safe. People like, especially if you're moving here from out of state, they like to come into these communities because they don't really know the area that well, right? Or they might not have any friends and family yet until they get to feel a little bit safer in some of these other communities, like I showed you in the first two properties where there is no HOA. That's why they like to come to these types of communities. Now, because you are in an HOA, there's pros and cons, just like everything else. Some of the cons can be the fact that you have to maintain your property a certain way. The community, the association will actually drive around and they'll ensure that everybody's got the yard trimmed up nicely. If your grass gets too high, they might send you a violation notice in the mail asking you to please start cutting your yard and taking better care of your property. They might tell you, hey, it's time for everybody to start washing their roofs. You need to start power washing your roofs. They're looking too outdated, too dirty. Or they can even come and say, this particular community has some amenities, and I'm getting ready to walk over there right now. I'm gonna show them to you. There's a clubhouse, which has a gym, a full gym, a resort style pool. It has a kid's playground, tennis courts, right? So a lot of cool things here. And if they have to update anything to the community amenities, then they'll go ahead and send out an assessment. And let's just say it costs them $10,000-$20,000 to redo the pool or the clubhouse. Then what they'll do is they'll take the total bill and they'll divide it amongst all the homeowners. So they'll tell you, hey guys, We have your regular HOA fee this month, and then there's a special assessment, a one-time fee of $500 just for this one-time expense, or you can choose to prolong it for 3, 6 months or a year, right? They'll give you options. They're not just gonna come out and say, you must pay this much right now. So they're pretty flexible with the homeowners. But those are all the things you guys should know if you're looking or if you're considering buying in a community that has an association, right? This particular house is in Maple Grove in the Walnut Creek community of Pembroke Pines, East Pines. As you can see right here, Walnut Creek, you got the clubhouse, Maple Grove that we just came in. You have the park, Palm Brook, and obviously the guardhouse that I came in through the main entrance, which I'm gonna include in the video as well. But look how nice this is. Like I said, it's resort style. And a lot of these clubhouses, they'll actually have an event room. If you're having a kid's birthday or a special event, a sweet 16, something like that, and you don't necessarily want to do it at your house, or you don't want to go rent a hall to have the special events, you can do it right here in the clubhouse. They have plenty of guest parking, right? They have a nice little roundabout driveway. You can drop people off if it's raining. Look, it's covered. You can offload everything there before you go park. So a lot of pros of living in a closed gated community. A lot of these homes were built in 2000. So they started building in late 90s, 2000. And here's the playground, as you can see. Again, it's all fenced in. So if you happen to be talking to a friend, your kid is not just gonna run out into the parking lot. A lot of great things that they've thought of that make living in these communities so appealing, right? So you have a lot of shade from the tree. So especially in the summertime where it's hot and humid here in South Florida, right? You can take some shade. Look at this, you got some tennis courts right here. And this is it, guys. This is Walnut Creek. This is the last stop for the day. Remember, part two is gonna be Central Florida. And stay tuned. I'm gonna take you to Pembroke Pines City Center. It's an area that the city of Pembroke Pines has started investing in, where they have a lot of great restaurants, some new shopping. There's more and more stores that are opening up every single week, every single month. So I'm gonna drive by, show you guys what the city's investing in. It's just a few minutes away. And I'll see you guys soon. Thanks for watching. So right now I'm driving around Pines City Center. This whole area was just built recently and it's full of great restaurants. There's still a lot of open retail spaces, but I'm sure that it's only a matter of time before they all get used up. They have pets grooming right here, beauty shop. An amazing Mediterranean restaurant. My wife and I just found that one recently and we absolutely love it. Then you have an Outback, Cooper Hawks, brand new Publix right here. There's a BurgerFi right across the street right there. There is a restaurant called, a pizzeria called Mr. 01 Pizza. And guys, you have to try it. It is an amazing restaurant. Right here we have, you know, all sorts of different retail, T-Mobile, Verizon, Paradise Grills, an outdoor kitchen.